assess your scrimmage and you specifically before you get to the offense yesterday?
I think I did pretty well. I didn't have a lot of reps yesterday. I had the ones I did have, I feel like I gave my all.
Did you get many with Worley?
No, that drive, they had took me out and replaced me with Bullard, and then they took Dallas out too, that drive. So it was Tiny, Marcus Jackson, Stone, and Bullard and Juwan when the drive of Worley was in.
So were there any fake injuries for you two? Since there was one for Bray, they didn't fake any injuries for you guys?
I didn't fake my injury.
what was that like? Did you guys know that was happening?
I really didn't know that until a couple of seconds ago. The other guy just told me. I had no idea what was going on.
I mean, how much would that prepare you guys in a practice if they did that?
I mean, it's a good situation to put us in those because, it happened last year, so. But it will prepare us a lot, though, for the season.
So who came in for you guys when you went out?
They took me out and they took Dallas out. So they put Marcus Jackson in and Alex Bullard in.
Okay, Alex in your spot and Marcus? Okay.
Dallas' spot, yeah.
All right. Hey, do you guys feel like you're pretty interchangeable left to right, like with your some of your twos right now to where they could jump in?
Yeah, our twos are really versatile. Bull's been playing every position since he's got here. Kyler Kurbison's playing every position. Marcus still holding down left guard spot, but we're pretty versatile on the second group.
How's James doing back at that center spot?
He's doing real good with his snaps. That's the main thing he's been focusing on all season.
I remember Coach Dooley last year said, "Well, he needed to get stronger." Do you see a stronger James Stone?
Yeah, he's working on it in the weight room this past off season, and he's increased his number by a lot.
How involved is Coach McKeefe with you guys after practice begins? We hear about the off season and the work there, but what's kind of his role with you guys during the season?
He's in charge of the warm-up, and he gets us going with the three of a kind every day. And just throughout the practice, he'll just motivate us and try to keep us going.
Is that chant that none of us can understand?
Yeah, that's basically what that is.
Do you know what's in that chant?
I've tried to hear him like a couple times, but I really don't know. He'll count his own way, and then he'll say switch or something. I don't know what he says, but it's close to that.
You just need to know to do whatever he says.
You got to know what to do when he's saying the stuff.
It's called three of a kind, though?
Three of a kind is the five up downs, five push ups, and five sit ups.
But the chant doesn't have a name that you know of, right?
No.
Talk about to your right and Juwan James and how he's doing.
Juwan's doing great. He's been increasing his weight room numbers already. He's already plays like he's strong anyway, so it didn't matter. And he's a great teammate, man. I've been proud to play by him for the last 3 years.
With the 3-4 and the versatility of that defense you guys are facing in practice, you're probably getting to block all kinds of different types of guys, aren't you? Talk about that.
I'm usually blocking like either a nose, and sometimes they have different like schemes and stuff, so they'll have like a 3 technique sometimes, or they'll try to fool us up. But I'm usually blocking the ends or helping Juwan out with the ends, so it's kind of fun to block those different variety of guys.
Now, when from your vantage point, when say Kurt Majid or AJ Johnson put their hands down, try to rush off the edge, and some of those other guys, what do you see from them, the defense in terms of their speed rush ability?
I think they're going to be great. They're going to produce a lot of sacks this year. I know Kurt's been working at it for a while now, and I think AJ's just starting out doing it. So I think they're going to be pretty good. It's going to be fun to watch this year.
How are you a better lineman now as opposed to at the end of last year in that Kentucky game?
I really just started to work on my flexibility and my strength a lot more as soon as the season ended. And I like broke my leg in the spring, so I had to come back off of that. And that helped me to do rehab and get stronger in my legs and stuff like that.
What's the most impressive thing you've seen about this offense so far in camp?
Just the maturity. We've all grown up. You know, we're bringing Tiny along with us. You know, Bray's just controlling the whole offense, and everything's running pretty smoothly.
Tiny's obviously a young guy, big young guy, but he seems like he has some leadership skills. Is there any sort of hesitation whatsoever from any of the older guys to follow the lead of a young guy like that?
No, not really. You know, Tiny's a cool guy, and everybody gets along with him. Everybody knows him outside of like practice and stuff, and we always hang out with him, so we don't have no problem with that.
So the chemistry thing in the off season, that was really necessary to improve that, right?
It was.
How good are these running backs?
Oh, they're going to be great this year. Rajon's been, in the past two scrimmages, Rajon's been doing great. So with Marlon and Devrin. That's going to be great this year.
Anything stand out to you about the defense going up against them? All the different looks are giving you, what stands out?
Stand out is Big Dan, Dan McCullers. He's like, I can never move him when we're blocking him, so especially try to get in his way and make sure he doesn't make the play. So he's going to have a great season.
Sorry, do you guys work on double and triple teams on him in practices and in the scrimmages, knowing that he might see that during the year?
With certain plays, we have to double him, so don't really – well, yeah, we do work on, like, we have to try to reach him instead of, like, trying to push him up the field because he'll just push us back. He's so strong.
I mean, you must look at the D-line now as opposed to what it looks like now, especially with the ones and even some of the backups too, and see that improved size from what you got. I mean, how drastic is that when you're lining up? You're like, wow, this is nothing like last year or the year before.
It's getting us prepared, and it's getting them prepared, too. Like I said, they haven't had much size in the past recent years, so this year they're going to have a big push on the line of scrimmage.
Jack, great to talk to you. Really appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you.